Hypoglycemic drugs are medications used to lower blood glucose in type 2 diabetic patients. Dietary glucose absorbed from the intestine passes by the liver before entering the general circulation. The liver controls glucose output to the blood by converting excess glucose into glycogen for storage. During a fast, glycogen is converted back to glucose to be released to the blood. Two major pancreatic hormones are involved, insulin and glucagon. Insulin is secreted in response to high blood glucose levels, such as after a meal. Insulin enables body tissues to uptake glucose, thus removing it from the bloodstream. Insulin also stimulates conversion of glucose into glycogen and fatty acids. On the other hand, low blood glucose levels induce glucagon release. Glucagon acts on the liver to promote conversion of glycogen back to glucose, as well as de novo glucose synthesis. While type 1 diabetes is caused by a low insulin production and can be effectively managed with insulin injections, treatment of type 2 diabetes is more complex. By definition, type 2 diabetic patients have a normal insulin level, but their tissues are not responsive to insulin. However, with time, some patients may also start losing insulin production. Hypoglycemic medications may promote insulin production, increase insulin responsiveness, decrease hepatic glucose output, reduce dietary glucose absorption, or increase glucose excretion in urine. Sulfonylureas inhibit the ATP-dependent potassium channel in pancreatic beta cells, basically hijacking the glucose-induced insulin secretion pathway. The result is an increased insulin release that occurs independently of blood glucose concentrations. Major side effects include hypoglycemia and weight gain. Some agents are associated with higher mortality for cardiovascular diseases. Meglitinides act in the same pathway as sulfonylureas, but via a different receptor binding site. They are shorter acting and produce a greater decrease in post-meal glucose, but otherwise have similar clinical efficacy and side effect profile as sulfonylureas. DPP-4 inhibitors inhibit the enzyme DPP-4 that inactivates the incretin hormones GIP and GLP-1. These hormones are released within minutes of food intake and act to stimulate insulin secretion and inhibit glucagon secretion. Their action is, however, short-lived because DPP-4 degrades them almost immediately. By inhibiting the DPP-4 enzyme, DPP-4 inhibitors prolong the action of incretin hormones, thereby lowering blood glucose. A notable adverse effect is a slightly increased risk for acute pancreatitis. GLP-1 receptor agonists mimic the action of GLP-1, but are much longer acting. They also slow down gastric emptying and reduce hunger, thereby lowering blood glucose levels as well as facilitating weight loss. They are most often administered subcutaneously due to poor oral bioavailability. Side effects are mainly gastrointestinal, although rarer but more serious adverse effects may occur. Thiazolidinediones are insulin sensitizers. They promote insulin-dependent glucose uptake in muscles and fat. These drugs activate the nuclear receptor PPAR-gamma that controls transcription of genes involved in glucose and lipid metabolism. Major adverse effects include peripheral edema, hypoglycemia, worsened heart failure, increased risk for cardiovascular events, and bone fracture. Metformin works by reducing hepatic glucose output and, to a smaller degree, increasing glucose uptake by peripheral tissues. Common side effects are gastrointestinal. Rarely, metformin can cause lactic acidosis, which can be fatal, and is therefore contraindicated in patients at risk of acidemia. Alpha-glucosidase inhibitors inhibit alpha-glucosidase enzymes that digest carbohydrates in the small intestine, thereby reducing dietary glucose absorption. Their major effect is a decrease in post-meal glucose. Side effects are mainly gastrointestinal. SGLT2 inhibitors inhibit the sodium glucose co-transporter responsible for glucose reabsorption in the kidney. Reduced glucose reabsorption means more glucose is excreted in urine and less is left in the blood. Major side effects include urogenital infections, ketoacidosis, and renal impairment.
Are you a fan of Alila Medical videos? If so, you will love our new Alila Academy. Based entirely on our highly effective animated mini lectures, our courses are designed to follow a typical syllabus in each subject. Each topic is extensively illustrated and comes with quizzes to test your understanding, downloadable PDFs for a quick review, as well as images for you to use in school projects or presentations. We are known for producing highly effective animated videos that explain the most difficult concepts in record time. We have no doubt that our courses will be a lifesaver for both students and teachers alike. So do come check them out. Alila Academy. Clear, concise, effective, with extensive visual resource. No one explains like Alila does.